Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.4 Developer Beta 6. This is available to developers now and may be out to public beta testers later today, tomorrow, or by the time you're watching this. It came in at 134.2 megabytes on my iPhone 10, and it installed pretty quickly. Let's take a look at the build number. The build number on this particular version is 16G5069A, and now that we're to the letter A, we're very close to the final version, or the Golden Master version, which is released to the public. So generally, the A denotes we're really basically at the end, so I would expect a final version maybe within a week or so, maybe 1 to 2 weeks away we'll have the final version, and this particular version seems to be all about the new Apple Card. So Apple Card should be coming out this summer. We're in the summer, according to Apple. It was supposed to be released in the summer or late summer, so we should see it maybe within a week or two. Now, this particular update does not have anything specifically new in it, with the exception of one resolved issue, according to the notes, and that has to do with the Xcode memory leak tool. So if you're a developer using Xcode and you're checking for memory leaks, or basically applications that are using memory continually and should not be, or when you close an application they could be using it, this actually resolves an issue. So let me read to you exactly what it says. They've resolved an issue where running an app in iOS 12.2 or later, so this has been an issue for a while, under the leaks instrument resulted in random numbers of false positive leaks for every leak check after the first one in a given run. You might still encounter this issue in simulator or in macOS apps when using instruments from Xcode 10.2 and later. So this should help developers as far as fixing issues with memory leaks and getting more accurate results. So as far as performance is concerned, performance seems to be pretty good. Swiping is nice and smooth on this particular version. 3D touch works nice and nice, just like it should, with pressure sensitivity. Everything's working well there. And swiping, you'll see speed is fast. Settings is not locking up for me. And as far as battery life is concerned, well, battery life, when I was running this before, seemed to get me about 5 hours or so, 5 to 6 hours. So it wasn't amazing, but it was pretty good. And you'll see I have not run it much on this particular device right now. And this one actually has 97% battery health. So not all of my devices have 100% battery health. This was used for a year and had that battery health after a year. But performance overall seems good. I'm having no lockups in settings, and I'm having no issues on any of the other devices I ran with it before. Performance with things like games seems to be good. You'll see it's resuming Minecraft here. And if we resume, games seem to be working well. If you're playing things like Fortnite, things like that, it should be just fine. So I haven't seen any issues as far as performance, and I did run a Geekbench just to give you a benchmark as what's going on here. We'll go into Geekbench, and you'll see that the single core was 4,143, multi-core was 10,316. This is actually a step up to the prior time I ran it. Now, I ran it twice because it does take a while after you run or install a beta to actually get good scores. So on June 24th, you'll see I got significantly lower when it comes to multi-core. So there's been a little bit of improvement there. It's not really anything to base as far as speed overall. It just gives you an idea as to the performance, and it seems to have increased. So that's it for iOS 12.4 Beta 6. I'd be very surprised if we see a Beta 7. I would expect to see a final within a week or two, like I said. And iOS 13, for those of you running that particular beta, I would expect a new one on the 15th or next Monday. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper as I always do. And if you have any other questions or comments, I would love to know which version you're on, and also how the performance, and also which device you're using. Let me know in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.